Yo, what's up, family? You cats know what it is. This is Celebrity Talk with Q, and you guys know that I'm Q. Yo, what's poppin'? How's my viral family? Y'all good? Yo, check this out. Real Housewives of Atlanta, Season 5, Episode 13, Recap and Review. It looks like the season is drawing near to the finale. And it looks interesting. So check this out. This episode opened up with Kenya and Phaedra still having a conflict about the workout video. You know what happened. Kenya felt that she should receive at least 10% on her back. And Phaedra said that I don't think you deserve 10%. And the whole thing just got, you know, somewhat ugly. So Kenya thought that she invite Portia to lunch to let Portia know that, look, you're just being a pawn in a beef between me and Phaedra. I guess she was trying to relate to her that I don't think that Phaedra is really feeling you as a friend like that. She's just trying to use you to continue to put a wedge between me and you due to the fact that her and I had a disagreement about the workout video. And, you know, Portia was trying to tell her, look, I'm not listening to it either way. You know, whatever beef you and I had, it got ugly on its own. So, you know, whatever Phaedra tells me about you, whatever anybody tells me about anybody, you know what, I'm not going to listen. I'll listen to what they have to say, but I'll make my own decisions. And Portia wasn't letting Kenya speak. And, you know, I guess Kenya got a little short patience. And she said to her, okay, forget it. I feel we can't have this conversation. And then Portia said that we can't have a woman-to-woman conversation. And Kenya said, I have to be sitting in front of a woman to have a woman-to-woman conversation. And, you know, I think that Kenya shouldn't have took it there. I mean, I can understand Kenya getting a little aggravated because Portia, you know, wasn't letting her speak or whatever. But she shouldn't have took it there. Then, you know, it just ended and they started insulting each other. Oh, with your sneakers. Oh, with your ashy feet. I mean, it just got really immature, if you ask me. I mean, I need to hear your thoughts on it, you know. But, yo, Portia, yo, the body is banging. Yo, did you see Portia when she walked away? Yo, what did you think about that? Yo, check this out. Everybody's talking about Portia. Oh, she's not too bright or what have you. But you know, a lot of that's probably jealousy or whatever. But check this out. If you got a woman with a shape like that, shoo. I do her thinking for her. What you got to say about that? Anyway, it goes on. The Cynthia Bailey agency is really, really growing. And she had the specialist come in. And she's adding a kid pageant to the roster. And it looks like that she's going to have a kid pageant. And it looks like she's going to do a good thing. But looks like she's going to make some money as well. Portia is joining Cynthia in that venture. It looks like Portia Nonprofit is going to contribute their expertise to the event. Now, Nene, as the episode continued, it showed how Nene went into a beautiful, beautiful store. Looks like she's trying to furnish her Hollywood Hills home because you know she's in LA filming The New Normal. And I've seen the show. It's kind of unconventional. I'm not going to tell you what's it about if you haven't seen it already. You have to see it yourself. It's kind of unconventional. It's new. At one time, the FCC may not have allowed a show like that to be on, but hey, we're in the millennium. You know, let folks do what they do. So it showed her and Greg, you know, in this beautiful, beautiful antique store, and they was buying different things. They was getting ready to buy different vintage artifacts and beautiful accessories to furnish her home. And, you know, that was cool. It's obvious. Looks like her and Greg is back together. I mean, it's obvious. As the episode went on, you showed Nene talking to her acting coach. And her acting coach was giving her a lot of great, great advice, was telling her to find your inner person. Even if it's not a person of your color and culture, that if you're a really talented actor, she's in there. As the episode moved on, we saw that Candy had chosen a Moroccan restaurant for all the ladies to meet at. Phaedra was there. Portia was there. Cynthia Bailey was there. And they were all eating and discussing situations. And Portia had explained to the girls what happened. Phaedra had explained what happened, but like Cynthia said, I don't think that Portia and Phaedra should have talked too much about Kenya because Kenya wasn't really there to defend herself. Now, as the episode moved on, you saw Kenya and Cynthia Bailey on the golf course. Yo, I don't know. Say what y'all want to say about Kenya, but the woman do look good. And they was talking about the situations. And now, here's the thing. Kenya was very, very offended that Phaedra was going around saying that she has a chemical imbalance, that she has a drinking problem. I mean, certain things Kenya had shared with Phaedra, thinking that they were friends. And as soon as they decide to have a business disagreement, Phaedra gonna go spreading this stuff. But that, I mean, that's childish. And not only that, I mean, a lot of lawyers do that. You know what I'm saying? A lot of lawyers sling mud just to make themselves appear more decent than they are. If you don't believe me, come to New York City. Okay, and get a New York City lawyer. I'm from New York City, and you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. So towards the end, NeNe had a Shoe Dazzle charity event. NeNe had just personally designed a shoe. And it looks like a beautiful shoe. I mean, it's a really high heel. So ladies, you know, if you're going to purchase that shoe, be careful. You know, make sure you know how to walk in that type of shoe. Don't run, because I wouldn't want, you know, you to get in any type of accident. And Kenya showed up. Oh my gosh, did you see what Kenya was wearing? She had on something. I guess she was mimicking Phaedra, because Phaedra had on a similar outfit when they was in Anguilla. And it just looked really, really crazy. I mean, me, myself, I thought it was inappropriate. But I guess, you know, being that Phaedra was telling everybody that she has a drinking problem, Phaedra was telling people that Kenya has a chemical imbalance, and Phaedra was just telling some of Kenya's personal business that Kenya had shared with her in confidence. I guess she wanted to mimic her and, you know, tease her. And did you see when Kenya got upset? Did you see how Kenya looked and said, "You know I don't have..." I don't know what she said. Did she curse or... I'm gonna lighten it up. "You know I don't have a problem." If she cursed, I'm not gonna curse, you know, in front of y'all like that. "But you know I don't have no problem." Yo, did you see that? Wow, Kenya got upset, yo. Wow. Now, this is what I need from you guys. I want you to send your comment. Yo, do you think Phaedra was foul for telling Kenya's personal business just because they had a business disagreement? Let me tell you something. When you do business, it separates the men from the boys, and it separates the women from the girls. Just because you have a business disagreement, you don't have to talk about nobody personally. That was childish on Phaedra's part. Now, I want you guys to send your comment. Was Phaedra wrong to go around spreading these things about Kenya, whether it was truth or lies? Was she wrong for spreading those things just because they had a business disagreement? Me, myself, I'm going to say she wrong, but it's not up to me. It's up to you guys. Send your comment and let me know what you think, all right? This is a quick episode, not too much drama, you know what I'm saying? Just touched on the little things. It showed Candy, you know what I'm saying? Get ready to decorate a room for her and Todd's future child, if they choose to have one. And it just touched on a lot of different things. But anyway, go on and send your comment. Let me know what you think about Phaedra spreading Kenya's business. Whether whatever she spread was true or false, was she wrong for that? I won't be the first to say she was wrong for that. All right, send your comment. And like we always say, if you think Celebrity Talk with Q, if you think we bring the real, you go on and subscribe. I'm going to get at y'all. Man, it's so good to be talking to y'all today. All right, God bless. Let me hear from you. 100. Oh,